Good evening, everybody. Tonight we're going to be singing Away in a Manger if you all want to join along and sing with us.
Good to have you with us tonight. We're doing something a little different this evening. Those of you at Victory Baptist Church already know that we do this on occasion when we have regular Wednesday night services, sometimes even Sunday night services. But with this special time of year and with so many things going on around us, we wanted to have a special praise and prayer request service tonight, praise and prayer service. And we're actually going to pray individually for some of the requests that have already been made. We're also going to be praising the Lord for some of the answered prayers that have already happened over the last few weeks. And so what we want to do is we want to invite you to go ahead and put a prayer request in the comment section. And this is how we want to try to do this tonight. We certainly want it to be honoring to the Lord in everything we do. But as you put those comments on the screen, we're actually going to have those handed to me, and we're going to pray individually over those. And so before we start tonight, I'd actually like to read a portion of God's Word and talk about how scriptural this is. And so we certainly don't want to do anything that's not biblical, something we can't back up in Scripture. And I'm not sure that James was talking about using Facebook Live or some of the technology that we're using tonight. But it's certainly God-honoring to be praising the Lord and praying over these certain things that we have in amongst us. And so James chapter 5, verse 13 says this. James chapter 5, and beginning verse 13, this is what the Bible says. Is any among you afflicted? Let him pray. Is any merry? Let him sing songs. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church, and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. And if he have any committed sins, they shall be forgiven. Confess your faults one to another, and pray for one another, that you may be healed. The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And so James is certainly talking to the modern day church today, as he was to the Christians of biblical times. And I have called our deacons, actually they're on a separate line and on a separate speaker, and between them and me, we're going to be praying individually for these things that we have been praying about on our prayer loop, the new things that you may have for us to pray for, and you may even want to put in an unspoken prayer request. And we'll certainly pray for that because we know God knows what that is. And so tonight, I'm just going to kind of get on my knees here, and we're just going to pray. And so I invite you all at home to pray over these that are mentioned. Again, if you have any prayer requests of your own, when we finish praying over the list, please add those to. Just call them out one at a time, and we'll certainly pray over those as well, okay? And so tonight on our list, we want to pray for Brother David Oakley. And so Brother David Oakley is a praise and still a prayer request. Brother David is still in the hospital. This is Miss Claire and Brother Jimmy's son, and he has had a miraculous recovery, still recovering, still needing prayer, but certainly recovering from COVID and pneumonia in both lungs. And so I'm going to start us off tonight praying for Brother David. Let's pray together. God, again, we want to praise you and thank you so much for this great news that we've been hearing over the last week or two about Brother David. God, we know that it's your hand of protection, your hand of healing that's involved in this. Lord, we pray that you would continue the healing. God, we pray that you would continue to comfort his wife and his family, God. We love you and trust you for all things. In Jesus' name I pray. The next one that's on our list is Brother Paul Rose. For those of you who do not know, Brother Paul is an insurance agent at Kentucky Farm Bureau here in Madisonville. He's a deacon at Liberty Baptist Church, a man that I grew up with, a fine man, a good Christian man. They had to take him to the emergency room last night with a high heart rate and possibly fluid around his heart. Brother Kenny, can you hear me okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'm going to ask you to pray for Brother Paul, please.
Father, Lord, I thank you for today and for everything in this day. Lord, we just praise you and lift up praises to you because we know we can take our prayers to you, our requests, and the things that are dear to our heart. Father, we pray tonight for Brother Paul Rose and his family. We pray for healing for him and for comfort and peace for his family. We know, Father, that you are the giver of all good gifts, the giver of life. And we just praise you and we lift up this man and his family to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Again, if you're just joining us on Facebook Live, we're doing a live prayer request and praise time. And so feel free to put in the comment section prayer request for yourself or for someone that God would lay on your heart. Or if you just have a praise and you'd like to give a shout out to God and let everybody know how good he's been to you, we want you to do that as well. So I'll stop and remind you about every two or three people just in case somebody's scrolling through and may not know what's going on in our service. So you do that, and I promise you, somebody's going to see that and hand it to me here at the end of our list that we already have pre-made, okay? At this time, we're going to ask Brother Darrell to pray for Miss Brenda Harvey. It's no coincidence, I'm sure, that this is Brother Darrell's time to pray because this is his grandson's mother-in-law. She was in Vanderbilt Hospital. And Brother Darrell, can you hear me okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'm going to ask you to pray for Miss Brenda Harvey. Would you do that, please?
Our blessed Heavenly Father, we thank you, first of all, for being such a good and a gracious and loving God. Lord, we just thank you for all the many blessings that you bestowed upon us. Now, Lord, we're coming with you with a heavy heart and knowing that Miss Brenda, whom we have known for so many years, Lord, and we feel like that she knows you and she has raised a wonderful family and they all rely upon you and give their testimony. And Lord, she is having physical problems right now. And Lord, we would ask you to, we know you're a great healer and you can do all things. And Lord, we're just asking you that you be with her. And if it be according to your will, Lord, we pray that you might touch her body and help her to be made well. And Lord, we ask all of these things that your name would be glorified. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Okay. Now we're going to be praying. Actually, this is a praise request, or not a praise request, but a praise that a prayer has been answered. This is actually for Brother Kenny's daughter and grandson. His daughter and grandson, Vance, Keenan, his daughter, had COVID. She is in the medical, she's a nurse anesthetist, I guess. Or I don't know what she is. Brother Kenny, what is she?
She's a nurse anesthetist.
So I did get that right. I was hoping I would. But I'm going to ask Brother Kenny to actually pray and thank the Lord for healing his daughter and his grandson. Brother Kenny, would you pray?
Yes. Father, we thank you for all the good gifts of life. We thank you for the forgiveness of our sins. And I ask you to do that now, Father. Just clean me up and use me for your glory.
Yes.
Father, I thank you for my daughter, my son, all of my family. Father, you've given me a wonderful wife, my children, grandchildren, and Father, we don't want to see any of them struggle. Yes. Father, we prayed and prayed, and our brothers and sisters prayed for Kenan and Vance during that time of COVID. And now that they are doing well, we just praise you, Father. We lift up praises to you because you alone are worthy. Yes. Father, we love you and we need you every day. Again, thank you for everything that you do for us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, my brother. This next one is also a praise that God has provided healing for Aaron and Crystal and Colton Richmond. We're thankful. I've talked to Aaron the last few weeks, a couple different times, and they're doing better. Haven't talked to him this week, but we certainly want to thank the Lord for the healing from the COVID virus in that family. Let's go to the Lord and pray. God, once again, we thank you so much for the healing that you provided to the Richmond family. God, we're so thankful for them, and God, for your grace and mercy in healing them from this virus. God, we just pray once again for this family. Bless Aaron as he leads, and Crystal, God, that they would be able to lead their family in a way that's honoring and pleasing you. Thank you again, Father, for what you've done in that family. For it's in Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Okay, again, just want to remind those of you that might be scrolling through for the first time, we're having a prayer service and praise time for the Lord. So if you have a prayer request, we're praying individually for those. Feel free to put those in the comments section, even if it is an unspoken, okay? All right, next on our list is actually Miss Beth Brown. This is Christy Kulioff's sister-in-law. And she has COVID. And so I'm going to ask Brother Darrell, would you pray for Miss Beth Brown in this COVID situation?
Heavenly Father, once again, as we humbly bow in your presence, Lord, we come to you with requests upon our heart for persons that have a great need for your healing hand. And Lord, I would just pray that you might look down upon Mrs. Brown and just get to heal her body and make her well again, and also that they could all enjoy the parts of life which you provide. For these things we ask in your name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, my brother. Next is actually Miss Sue Weinbarger. Miss Sue Weinbarger is one of our ladies at church who's been having eye problems, and she's finally scheduled for eye surgery, I do believe, on the 14th. And so she's very nervous and very concerned about this, and we want to pray for peace for her and also for the healing of her eye. Brother Kenny, would you pray for Miss Sue, please?
Yes. Father, Lord, we thank you for your love towards us. We thank you for this time of year when we think about the birth of our Savior Jesus.
Yes.
Help us to always remember, Father, also that it's his death, his blood, that gives us the freedoms that we have. Father, tonight we lift that to you from Sue. She's been struggling with this eye problem. We pray, Father, that you would comfort her fears. Just give her a peace about this procedure. Father, we already know that the doctor she's seeing is very capable of doing this procedure. And we just pray, Father, that she regains full vision in her eye. But more than anything, Father, we want her to have comfort. Yes. We want her to trust in you and to know your strength, your power. We love you, Lord, and we're confident in your ability. In Jesus' name, I ask these things. Amen.
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 Next, we're going to be praying for Raymond Collins. And actually, not just Raymond, this is actually Miss May's nephew. He has COVID. Miss May asked us to pray for him. But we're going to pray for Sue, her daughter, and just Miss May's family. Miss May has always been very concerned about her family. She asked for prayer every week about somebody in her family for a spiritual condition or for a physical condition. And so we're just going to pray for not only Raymond Collins, Miss May's nephew, but all of her family. Let's pray together. Father, again, I thank you for the faithfulness of Miss May to lift up prayers to you and, Father, to ask the church to call out in their names. Father, we hold her family up to you. Lord, we pray that, Lord, you would provide healing from this COVID for Mr. Collins. And, Lord, we pray again also for the rest of her family, for Sue, Lord, again, that you would help her to find her will or your will in her life, Lord. And we pray for Miss May to be strong. To continue to pray for her family and that they would see her faithfulness, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray, and amen. Next is actually a praise and a continued prayer request. Miss Audrea Melton has been joining our church, and Miss Audrea has been cleared from the COVID virus. She had it, but she still has a lot of medical issues, seeing a heart doctor, cardiologist, and then also praise for her granny. Her granny had fell. I don't know if they're watching tonight, but I hope they are. But granny fell a little while back, and she was in the hospital, and she's had some rehab and some things, and she was doing better. Hope she still is. And again, we want to thank the Lord for healing in that family. Brother Darrell, would you pray for Miss Audrea's family and her granny, please?
Yes, once again, Lord, as we humbly bow in your presence and call upon you. Lord, we just want Miss Andrea to feel your presence in her. We thank you so much for the fact that you have looked after her and made her better and all. But Lord, we ask that you continue to guard her body and help her, and Lord, and to overcome and not once again not be troubled with any bad feelings. Lord, we just pray that. We also ask that, Lord, that you be with her granny, Ella May. Lord, she is an old time acquaintance of ours, and Lord, we thank a lot of her and Miss Andrea both, and we ask, Lord, that you just guide them and you direct them and you bless their lives, Lord, and make it possible for them to enjoy what time you have given for each one of us. For these things we ask in your name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, if you're just joining us on Facebook Live, you may have been scrolling, don't even know why you stopped. We are having a prayer service and praise service for prayer requests and praises where the Lord has answered prayer. Feel free to put prayer requests in the comments section, even if it's an unspoken, and we're going to just do what the Bible says, and we're going to call out to the Lord. And so we are having going through the list, plus the ones that have been posted. Next, we're going to be praying for Miss Carolyn Drury. Miss Carolyn has been through a breast cancer surgery, is in treatments right now. I don't know how she's been doing over the last week and a half, 2 weeks. But we certainly want to remember her. Brother Kenny, would you ask the Lord to bless Miss Carolyn?
Yes. Father, Lord, we thank you for your love, your mercy, and as we continue our prayers to you, Father, we lift up to you Miss Carolyn, David, and the family. We love them all. We certainly miss them. And we pray, Father, for, first of all, for healing. Yes. We just pray for a touch from you upon Miss Carolyn's body. Brothers, we continue to lift them up to you day in and day out. We're reminded of so many good memories with that family. And we just pray, Father, that you give them many, many more years together. We pray for their comfort, their peace, as they go through this time. We pray for the doctors that touch them and heal them. And we just pray your love and your mercy and your grace upon them. Heal them, Father, if it be your will. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, my brother. Next, we're actually going to pray for my cousin. Her name is actually second cousin. This is my mother's brother, Uncle Larry, if you all are watching out there. This is his granddaughter, Angela. And so she has COVID, and Uncle Larry has told me that she's not doing very well. So we want to pray for her. Name is Angela. So let's pray together. Father, once again, we pray for Angela. Lord, we pray that you would touch her body. Lord, we pray that you would heal her from the inside out. God, we don't know if she knows you as Savior or not, but God, we also pray for spiritual healing if that's needed as well. God, we love her and we love her family. God, we pray once again that you would heal her in accordance to your will. And thank you so much for what you're going to do. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Okay. Next on our list, we're going to be praying for a bereaved family, the Kelly Adams family. And so, Brother Darrell, if you would you lift up this family to the Lord, the Kelly Adams family?
Yes, Lord. Once again, we know that you are the great comforter.
Yes.
You can give comfort and all to as no one else can, Lord. And
amen.
Lord, we have experienced it from your hand, Lord, and you've done so much for us. And Lord, I would ask that you be with the Kelly Adams family. Lord, we know that they are in need of your helping hand. And Lord, we just pray that you might just give them the comfort and peace and all
to come. Yes. Amen.
And that we don't know for sure, but we hope and we pray that he has already accepted you as his personal Savior. But if not, Lord, we still ask that you bless the family in every way. For we ask it in your name. Amen.
Amen. And again, if you're just scrolling through Facebook right now, stop at our page. We are having a praise and a prayer service live. If you would like to put any praises or prayer requests into the comment section, that would be handed to me here in just a little bit. And we're certainly going to pray live for them or praise the Lord for something that he's done in your life here recently. And so the next person on our list that we have, we're going to be praying for is actually Holly Ellis. This is Brother Kenny's nephew. Actually, Brother Kenny's nephew's fiance. This person is in the hospital in Lexington, I do believe Brother Kenny said. Brother Kenny, would you offer them up to the Lord, please?
Yes. Father, first of all, we just have to just praise you again. Thank you, Father, for the gift of life that you've given us. We praise you, Father, for our family and for the season that we're in. Father, tonight we know there's many people struggling. We think about Stephen and Holly. We pray, Father, first of all, that both of them know you as their personal Savior. We pray, Heavenly Father, tonight that they're looking to you and praying to you and counting on you for life. We pray, Father, that you touch Holly's body. We pray that you heal her, Father.
Yes.
Father, we pray more than anything that it would be your will that our prayers are seeking. Father, we pray for Stephen. We pray for strength as he is very, very concerned about his fiancée. And we just pray, Father, that as time moves on, that they see your hand in everything that happens. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, my brother. Now, we're going to pray, and these are some of the requests that have just come in since we started tonight. We're going to pray for Sarah and Veda. Don't know the last name, but they have COVID. Daughter and granddaughter of Mark Oakley. So let's pray for Sarah and Veda as they have this COVID virus. Let's pray together. God, again, we pray for these two. Lord, we know that our brother Mark is concerned about them. Lord, and we just understand that as loved ones, we can't do anything for them. But God, we know that you can. God, we know that we're going to lift them up to you. And God, we pray for healing if it be your will. Again, God, we want them to be healed. And we want you to receive all the honor and glory and praise that you're so worthy of. Thank you, Father, for doing this in Jesus' name. Amen. The next
Amen.
One. This is actually my father's brother and wife. It's my Uncle Earl and Aunt Ima. And they have some physical needs. And I'm going to ask Brother Darrell, would you offer them up to the Lord tonight, please? Earl and Ima.
All right, Heavenly Father, once again, we call upon you, and we know that you're more than able to answer and all requests. And Lord, we just pray that this family that has been mentioned here, Lord, that you might put your hand of comfort, hand of healing, hand of strength, and all upon them, Lord, and make them realize that what good it comes from you. And Lord, we just pray that this might be the case. And we ask, Lord, now that you bless them for in your name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, my brother. I also have, this is another one from my family. Brother Kenny, this is actually my nephew, Corbin Caskey. There's not anything on here specific, but would you lift little Corbin up? I think he's probably fifth grade, maybe sixth grade, not sure, but fifth grade I'm getting from my daughter.
He has a fever.
Okay, so would you pray, Brother Kenny, for
yes, sir.
Corbin?
Father, Lord, we love you. We need you. We call on you tonight, Father, to touch little Corbin.
Yes.
We pray for him, Father, that whatever this is that's causing his fever, that you take care of it, Lord.
Yes.
We just pray that it's gone by morning.
Yes.
Father, we know your power. We know your capability. We just ask these things within your will.
Yes.
Father, remembering what it was like to be a fifth grader.
Yes.
And what a great time in life that is. We also know that children are very strong. They're very resilient. And even though they get sick from time to time, we just count on you for healing.
Yes.
Father, we pray again that you touch little Corbin, bless his body, and heal him up. May he know you as his Savior.
Yes.
In Jesus' name. Yes. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, my brother. Again, if you're just scrolling or passing through, we are having a prayer and praise service here at Victory Baptist Church, and we're inviting anybody that comes to be a part of that. All you have to do is put your praise or prayer request in the comments section there, and we will pray individually over that. The Bible says to call the elders of the church together, and we've done that, and they're live on another phone, and they'll be praying. As you pray, those of you that are also listening, please pray as we lift these families and these concerns up to the Lord, okay? Our next one is Josh Harris. This is Miss Sherry's sister. Those of you at Victory Baptist Church, this is Gana. and it's Miss, her sister's son-in-law, and so that family's dealing with COVID. Miss Lana's had it, and several other people in Sherry's family. So let's lift Josh Harris up to the Lord. Let's pray together. God, once again, we just ask that you touch this family. God, we pray that you'll touch Josh. Father, again, we don't know his spiritual condition, but God, we know you do. And Lord, first of all, we pray that he would turn his heart and life over to you if he's not a Christian. If he is, Father, we pray that he's seeking you for healing and for those things in his life. And God, we just want to give you all the honor and praise and glory for healing. Healing, Father, and even this other parts of the family that are struggling with this. God, we ask you to do this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. The next one is actually Holly Peterson, Thule. This is, Ganna's niece. And so, Brother Darrell, would you lift up Holly Peterson, please?
Yes, our Heavenly Father, as we come to you one more time and call upon you, we know, Lord, that you are the great healer, the great provider. And, Lord, we just ask that you be with this family that whose name has been mentioned. Lord, we don't know all their circumstances, but you do. And, Lord, we just pray that they might look to you for guidance in all of these things. And if it be healing that is needed, Lord, we know you're the great healer. If it's comfort, Lord, we know you're the great comforter. Yes. Whatever the case might be, Lord, we just pray that you will be with them and they will know you and rely upon you. Well, these things we ask in your name. Amen.
Amen. All right. Let me see. Again, if you have any prayer requests or praises, we're going to give you a few minutes. That's all that was on my list. And unless somebody on our phone, other phone line, let me turn this up. Does anybody have a praise or prayer request on the phone line? Anybody want to mention?
Yes, Brother Andy. I have so many things to be thankful for. Lord, he has blessed me for several years that I didn't expect to have. And Lord, I thank him so much for that. I thank him for my family that he has given me and how they have blessed my life. I thank him, Lord, for my church family, Lord, and how they have been such a great comfort to me down through the years and all the different troubles that we have through the loss of loved ones, loss of a wife, loss of a mother and father, Lord, and many good friends, Lord, that in all of that, they have been right there with me. And Lord, now I'm looking forward to this celebrating Christ's birthday. Lord, I'm looking forward to that. But Lord, I have families that's going to be traveling and coming to me. And Lord, I just pray that you will be with them. You'll protect them. You give them the protection which they need. Lord, we know that in all cases, we feel in our heart that they love you as much as I do. And Lord, I just pray that you would bless them. Now, Lord, we thank you for this and for the testimony which you've allowed me to give through the years. For asking your name. Amen.
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 Anybody else, before we close, and one final prayer. Anybody else have anything on the comments?
Hey, brother.
Yes.
We mentioned Beta and Sarah.
Yes.
That's Mark and Hannah's daughter and granddaughter. I just want to lift up Mark to the Lord because of his lung problems.
Yes.
And I'm thankful to have him for a neighbor.
Amen.
He's been a great neighbor.
Well, Amen.
You go ahead and pray,
and,
brother.
I love him, and I just I pray for him, and I want him well. I just pray that the good Lord will provide a lung transplant for him and heal him up. And I pray that the Lord hedge him from that COVID that I know has possibly been through his going through his family. I praise the Lord for Jerry and Sherry and for their family, and I know that they're going through a lot right now. Sure do love your daddy and your stepmom.
Amen.
And praise the Lord for them. I'm looking forward to seeing my family here in the next few days as we celebrate Christmas and as we celebrate the birth of Jesus, but we also celebrate family.
Yes.
And I love my church family. I pray for Miss Sue and Miss May and Mom and all of our older folks, Buddy Darrell. And it's a blessing to me to have him able to pray, to lift up prayers and request to the Lord for others at his age. I just praise the Lord for him and all that he's been to me down through the years. God is good, and I praise him.
Amen. Someone else? Okay. Just got a prayer request from Miss May to pray for Margaret Smith's family. Some of her family has COVID, so let's pray for Miss Margaret's family. God, again, we understand and know that you knew the situation again with Miss Margaret. And God, we first prayed that you would bless her and her body. And God, help her to continue to have strength to praise you and to help her family, to lead her family. God, but we pray for this COVID virus that you would heal those people in her family in accordance to your will. God, give her strength once again to praise you as she's the matriarch of her family. In Jesus' name I pray. Okay. Someone else. You know, I was just sitting here thinking, well, my knees sure are getting tired and sore right now. But don't you think we should have tired and sore knees as Christians? I don't think there's a better thing we can do for somebody than to pray. I'm reminded to pray for my buddy Bo. Those of you who know Bo have been coming to church. Pray for him and the cancer that he found in his body, or that the doctors found. So let's pray for Bo. Father, once again, I pray that you would bless my friend. God, we again pray for healing in his body. Lord, only you know the extent of it, but God, we're trusting you to heal it. God, we pray that you'll help him to make the decisions and to turn to you and for all those things, God, and for the peace as he seeks to be healed. Lord, we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. We're praying.
Someone else.
Amen.
I'm sorry, I missed that. Let me turn you up here a little bit more. Okay, tell me again, sis. Okay. Okay, well, I'll tell him, sis, okay?
Okay.
Brother Kenny, that was Miss Donna praising the Lord for you and how you helped her family and how you helped them to get a Christmas tree.
God is good.
Amen. Amen. Brother Kenny, you want to pray and thank the Lord for the ability to serve and for Miss Donna and Brother Tony.
Amen. Lord, we thank you again that you're always there, ready to listen to our prayers. Father, we thank you for the ability, the strength that you've given us, the health that you've given us in order to be able to serve you. Father, we know that we're feeble in our own ways. But Father, you've given us certain resources that make us able to help others. We pray, Father, that you'll use us and our efforts to be a blessing to others. And so, Father, we pray for Donna and Tony. We know that the health struggles that Tony has, the struggles that Donna has in taking care of him, and we just pray, Father, as we lift them up to you, that you take care of their needs. Bless them, Lord, as only you can. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. I have a prayer request, and the request is for Mark. I hope they get better quick and stay safe. And this is from Brother Randy Lanive. And we want to once again pray and ask the Lord to bless Mark. So, Brother Darrell, would you do that, please, on behalf of Brother Randy Lanive? Pray for Mark and for the Lanive family as well.
I certainly will. Lord, we're coming to you again with requests upon our hearts, Lord, for our two good friends that we have. And, Lord, we would like very much for them to experience your healing hand upon their bodies. And Lord, we just pray that you might be with them. You might strengthen them. You might just take away whatever is being their problem now. We know,
yes,
Lord, that you are the great healer.
Yes.
And
yes,
you can do that. But Lord, if that's not within your will, Lord, then we ask that you give them the great comfort which we know that only you can give. Lord, we know from experience, Lord, that you can give comfort when no one else can. And Lord, but first of all, we ask, Lord, if it be within your will, you heal their body. They're two good friends, and we would like for them to be around for a long time. Yeah.
Amen.
Your name. Amen.
Amen.
You know, I don't pray for this, but Big R, if you're listening out there, I would just almost pray that you would kill a limit of ducks tomorrow. Just not real, not going to, but just almost. But my brother certainly prayed that for your health and in the leadership of you and your family. I have a prayer. Actually, he's already praying for us. This is from Wesley Curtis. Those of you that know Brother Wesley out at Green Grove Baptist Church, he says that he's praying for all of us at Victory, and he's praying that God would bless us. And so, Victory Baptist folks and anybody out there would like to, let's pray and thank Brother Wesley for his prayer concerns and for Green Grove. And let me tell you something. You know, a lot of people talk and say they're praying for you. Brother Wesley sends me a message every Sunday morning. And the group of pastors that we have there with our Baptist churches that we have our revival, joint revival and stuff with, he sends us all a message every Sunday morning talking about how we give our people heaven and how we need to trust in the Lord and how he's praying for us every Sunday morning. And so I'm so thankful for my brother's faithfulness and the reminder to me to be praying for my sister churches. And so let's pray for Brother Wesley and Green Grove Baptist Church. Father, once again, I thank you for my brother. Lord, I pray that you would bless him as he proclaims the word at Green Grove. God, help him to be a shepherd to those people there as they don't put him on a pedestal, but God, put you on a pedestal. And our better followers of Christ and more like him because of his leadership at that church. God, we pray that you'll bless them, not only with numbers, but the fellowship. God, we pray that you would hedge it and protect it from the enemy. God, we love him and we thank you for him. In Jesus' name I pray, and amen. Okay, any other prayer requests or praises? All right, well, you can go ahead if you see this. You are, hang on just a second. Yes, did you have one? Amen. If you all didn't hear Miss May Rahoff says that she just wants to thank the Lord for another day. Okay. What's that, Miss May?
Amen.
You're thankful for your pastor. Did you say that, Miss May? No, I don't think she said that, but I bet you, she prays for her pastor all the time. And so thank you, Miss May, for that. Let's close one more time in prayer and just thank the Lord for his many blessings. And if you see this and you want to put more prayer requests down at the bottom, they will be seen. They may not be seen right away, but I promise you, people will see those and we'll lift your concern and take it to the Lord. Let's pray and thank God once again. Father, again, I'm just so thankful to be sitting here with my family, God, and my church family, those who have tuned in, God, those who have been on calls. Lord, I miss them. And Lord, I pray that you would just provide protection for them. God, we know that this COVID situation doesn't seem to be getting much better. And God, we know no matter how many vaccines are out there, that you're in control of it. And God, once again, we pray that you would lift it from us and that you would heal those that have it. But God, once again, help us to see if there's something you'd have us to see or something you'd have us to do or something you'd have us to change. And God, help us to do that and see that before you remove it. And God, we pray once again for each family during this Christmas time. Lord, we pray for those that are without loved ones. God, I think about my friend Steve and third, second mother Jean Knight. Lord, we just thank you so much for them. If they're out there, I know they're going to be dealing with the loss of Brother Danny. And God, we just pray that you'll hold them and give them peace again, Father. And for all those that are struggling with the loss of loved one. And God, again, we just want to lift the name of Jesus up. God, we pray that through this message or through this prayer time that somebody would come to a saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. God, what a great gift that you provided for us by your son dying on the cross. And Lord, I pray that they would call out to Jesus and confess their sins to him and ask him to save them and forgive them before it's everlasting too late. God, thank you again for everything you do for us, for your grace and for your mercy. Bless my church family and my family, God, and all those who are listening, for it's in Jesus' name I pray, and amen. Thank you once again for joining us tonight. And as my brother said, we want God to receive all the honor and all the glory. Thank you again for joining us. Good night.